unbelievable. Canadian government, through support for Nnamdi Kanu's trial, ordered his immediate release or else. Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami, has questioned the legal savviness of the Solicitor General of the Provincial State of Alberta in Canada, Kelechi Madu, over the latter comments on the arrest of the leader of the Indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu. In a statement on Wednesday by his spokesman, Omar Gwandu, the AGF described the ideas attributed to Mr. Madu as outrageous and ignominious, opinion that are eccentric and weighed in the legal professional. He said, "It is unfortunate for someone who claims to be a lawyer of a status of a Solicitor General of the Provincial State of Alberta in Canada to fault the internationally recognized manner through which Nnamdi Kanu, who jumped the bail, was rearrested and brought back to face trial." Malami said it was abundantly clear that a bench warrant was lawfully and judiciously procured through judicial process by a competent court of law, whose bail condition Kanu breached with impunity. According to him, there was no illegality in the entire process. He said it is a common principle of law that he who comes to equity must come with clean hands. The self-acclaimed leader of the proscribed group of the Indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, has enjoined representations by counsel of his choice all through the judicial process. He was never denied a right of choice of counsel or recourse to one, even when he symbolized a proscribed association. IPOB in law and in fact his association has been legally proscribed. Where was Madu when Kanu was inciting violence against the country? Why, as a lawyer, would Madu support a fugitive who jumped bail and is accused of terrorism and treason felony? What stopped Madu from voicing out dissent on the atrocities of Nnamdi Kanu and their group? Malami asked. He maintained that it was important to educate people that both Nigeria and Canada were signatories of multinational treaty agreements, where, among others, fugitives fleeing justice in nations with similar agreements could be brought back to face justice. It is a pity that, as a Solicitor General of a province, Madu fails to keep himself acquainted with the provisions of general laws of the country where he stays, as well as international laws, said Madu. See who is talking. See who is talking, my viewers. What are we going to say about this? Look at Malami. When we are talking about lawyers, Malami should just lock himself indoors. He should just pretentiously lock himself indoors and pretend nothing ever happened. Do you understand? When we are talking about lawyers and when we are talking about laws, Malami is not supposed to be talking. You understand? He's not supposed to be talking because he has committed the unbelievable. He has committed the unbelievable. Look at who he's talking. Have you forgotten the error you have committed as a lawyer? Have you forgotten the rubbish you've said as a lawyer? Have you forgotten? President Mubari called AGF Malami. He called him. He said that go and check the section of the constitution that warrants open grazing in all the regions in Nigeria. Buhari gave him that assignment as a reliable barrister, who is also a son, to let you know the length at which Buhari believed in AGF Malami. Do you believe that AGF Malami went to check the constitution? Eh? Only to come back and start giving Buhari a useless feedback that yes, that there is a section in that constitution that supports that. Who is fooling who? Who is lying to who? Thank God we have prominent lawyers. We have prominent lawyers who are not, who in fact, the person that detected the truth about the open grazing is even someone that is not a son. So this son of a thing, senior advocate of Nigeria, to me, that title is being bought. So someone like Malami bought that title to himself because of the schools that he has attended in law. Do you understand? So thank God we have prominent lawyers. So it was these lawyers that actually checked the constitution and discovered the lies that Malami told. He doesn't understand the constitution. He doesn't, one bit. So checking the constitution, they have to discover that, and they have to raise alarm and said, never, there is nothing of such in the constitution. That section Malami is quoting is only recognizing open grazing in the northern region. And he gave reasons. He said that they accepted that in the northern region because they believe that they have that fertile land. The fertile land for the business, and that is what the northerners are very good at. So they have to give them that opportunity. That opportunity. You understand now? They have to give them that opportunity so that they can go in and what? And do the business. You see that? You see that? So going in. Oh my God. In fact, I'm happy. I'm very, very happy that this was later discovered anyway. Do you understand? I'm very happy. So that was how the you see that this Buhari is now cunningly and pretentiously start forgetting everything about open grazing gradually. You can see that. So my dear viewers, let us not get it twisted. These people are just deceiving themselves. Let me hear from you from the outside to know what you have to say. If you are new, click on the red subscribe button as well as the bell button to get updated each time we upload any new videos. Thank you.